In this video, we are going to consider addition and subtraction of rational solids. Let's consider 1 over the square root of 2 plus 1 over 3 root 2. Step number 1. This will multiply this, and we are going to have 3 root 2. Next, we're going to bring down this plus. Next, root 2 multiply by 1. And here we're going to have root 2. Next, we're going to draw a line at the denominator. This will multiply this. And we're going to have root 2 multiply by 3 root 2. Remember, we went like this first, plus, then like this. And lastly, we considered the denominator. Next, this is like 1. If this is mango and this is mango, we're going to have 3 mangoes plus 1 mango. And we're going to have 4 mangoes. Next, at the denominator, this is 1. 1 multiplied by 3 is 3 times root 2 times root 2 is 2. Remember that the square root of a multiplied by the square root of a is the same thing as a to the power of half times a to the power of half. If you apply the law of indices, you're going to have a to the power of 1 over 2 plus 1 over 2. This is a. 1 over 2 plus 1 over 2 is 1. And anything to the power of 1 will return itself. Because of this rule, the square root of 6 times the square root of 6 will give you 6. The square root of 2 times the square root of 2 will give you 2. The square root of 3 times the square root of 3 will give you 3. This is why the square root of 2 multiplied by the square root of 2 will give you 2. Next, here we are going to have 4 multiplied by root 2 divided by 6. Next, we can write this as 4 divided by 6 multiplied by root 2. 2 can go here twice. 2 can go here 3 times. And our answer becomes 2 root 2 divided by 3. And this becomes our answer. For the complete video course on this subject, click the link in the description or in the pinned comment section. Let us consider 2 divided by the square root of 3 minus 1 divided the square root of 2. Step number 1. We're going to move towards this direction first, which is towards the left. And we're going to have that the square root of 2 multiplied by 2, we're going to have 2 root 2. Next, we're going to bring down this minus. Next, the square root of 3 multiplied by 1 will give us the square root of 3. That is, we have just moved towards the right. Divide. Next, we're going to consider the denominator. The square root of 3 multiplied by the square root of 2. Here, we are going to have 3 multiplied by 2. Both are inside this square root. And here, we are going to have 2 root 2 minus the square root of 3 divided by the square root of 6. Next, we are going to rationalize this. That is, we're going to have 2 root 2 minus the square root of 3 divided by the square root of 6. We are going to take this square root of 6 and multiply the numerator and also the denominator. This can cancel this, and we are going to get back this. Next, this will multiply everything here. Let's start with the numerator. The square root of 6 will multiply 2 root 2. And we're going to have 2, the square root of 2 times 6. This is having a square root, and this is having a square root. Both will go into this square root. There is a minus. I will put a minus. The square root of 6 multiply the square root of 3. And we are going to have 3 multiply by 6 inside the square root. Next, at the denominator, the square root of 6 multiplied by the square root of 6 will give us 6. Next, here we are going to have 2 the square root of 12 minus the square root of 18 all divided by 6. Next, this square root of 12, we are going to break it down. That is, if you have the square root of 12, we are going to draw a line. We are going to write 12 here. We are going to start with 2. 2 divided by 12 will give you 6. Next, 2 will go again. 2 into 6 will give you 3. 2 cannot go without a remainder. Hence, we are going to go with 3. 3 into 3 is 1. Next, we are going to pair. If you pair this 2 is 3. So we are going to write 2. 3 is not 3. Hence, we are going to put it inside the square root. Hence, the square root of 12 is the same thing as 2 root 3. Hence, here, we are going to write 2 times, instead of the square root of 12, I'm going to write 2 root 3. We are done with this. Here, we have a minus. Next, this square root of 18, we're going to draw a line. I'll bring out 18. I will start with the smallest number 2. We're not going to consider the negative integers 0 and 1. We're going to start with 2. 2 into 18 will give you 9. 2 into 9 will leave us with a remainder. So we're going to go with 3. 3 into 9 is 3. 3 can still go. 3 into 3 is 1. Next, we're going to pair. 3 got a pair. So this 3 is free. 2 has no pair. So we're going to have, hence, the square root of 18 is 3 root 2. Instead of this, I'm going to write 3 root 2. At the denominator, we're going to have 6. Next, I'm going to separate this because this 6 is under this and this 6 is under this. Hence, I'm going to have 4, 2 times 2 is 4 root 3 divided by 6 minus 3 root 2 divided by 6. Next, 2 here is 2 and 2 here is 3. I'm going to have 2 root 3 divided by 3. Next, I will have a minus. 3 here is 1. I'm going to be left with root 2. Divide 3 here is 2. And this becomes our answer. We don't have any square root at the denominator. And this is stable. If you find this video helpful, please click the like button. Also, subscribe for more videos like this. I will see you in the next video.